Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 28 of my Resident Rise Let's Play. And first of all, this video should air on Valentine's Day, so, well, happy Valentine's Day. what I want to do today is, well, quite a lot of small things, pretty much. First of all, I want to make a little bit of a liquid crafting system, for example, so I can create moss. I want to create a fissure. I want to be able to go to the Twilight Forest. I'll hold this off to when it's actually Valentine's Day, also in real life, because I record these episodes a little bit ahead. Then I want to make an automatic mana bean farm, which would be very nice. And then I also want to get that armor stand room done someday. Not sure when, but yeah, I'll get it done someday. So what I did between the episodes. I got kind of bored, so I replaced all the trees that I had with silverwood trees, so they actually still serve sort of a use. That's pretty cool. Now I got a lot of magical forest areas around this. So yeah, that's pretty cool actually. And also, as you can see, these things carry, or at least some of them carry, some pure nodes. So that's what's creating the areas around it. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I upgraded these to diamonds because, well, let me turn this down a bit. As you can see, I'm producing way too much materials. It's really amazing though, but yeah. I'm not going to be low on wood anytime soon. At least, I'm not expecting to be. Don't worry. Let me quickly do some of this. Dump it into my system, actually. So, yeah. So, I will be able to have some wood in my system. And I'll need to change up all the patterns to normal wood soon, too. So, I don't have to use the other types of woods, actually, in this. But, yeah. That'll hold off. What else did I do? Like I said, I made a little gift for these people. I can show you guys right now because this episode should only air on Valentine's Day, so. I made myself a bunch of regeneration potions, which I renamed to love potions. And I am planning to give these to each person on the server. So basically, a thank you note to, well, yeah, all the people that play on the server. And for everything they've done for me and the community and everything, basically. Just little gift, but will be pretty nice, I hope. Then what I also did is, I'm not sure if I did this episode or previous one, but I think I forgot to mention it. I changed the glass up to these paving stones of warding. They look quite a lot nicer. These are Towncraft stuff, by the way. Then what I also did is, right here, I made a automatic off switch. Basically, I made myself a bunch of diamonds or gates, because, well, I got a bunch of diamonds and materials, so why not just simply use diamonds even though I don't need them. So basically, if there's space in this or items in this inventory, emit a red pipe signal. And I got this connected up to a little bit of a different system. Change it up a bit. As you can see right there. Emit a redstone signal, a red pipe signal, and an end gate. And to connect it to a timer. So basically, if I place some bone meal in this thing. Let me quickly remote order something. Bone meal. Like, let's say, stack of three. And simply quickly wait just a second or two. There we go. And I put this in this thingy. This thing will start working again. Unless, of course, I turn it off manually. Because it's an end gate. Pretty nice. As you can see, this thing has also been producing tons of materials. And I love it. So, also something I've been doing is already starting to grow some mana beans. Or, well, these things when they hang are called mana pots. I figure that out soon. But yeah, I want to harvest these things. Because, well, if I quickly break some of these, they have a chance to give you two instead of one. But basically, these carry one of each type of essence. So basically, if I would be able to mass farm these things, I wouldn't ever need some, well, need to simply dump items in the system, the infusion crafting system again, because I can simply use this. And that should be pretty nice. And I believe the current way that we have that is, or the only possible way that we currently have that can farm mana beans is with golems, and not, I believe in a newer version, My Factory Reloaded also supports these things, so that should be pretty cool eventually. So, yeah. So, like I said, today I want to start working on, first of all, a little moss crafting system. And this should be a pretty easy to set up system. Let me quickly look up extra cells. And for that, I need one of these fluid crafting chambers. Let's see, how much materials do I have? Not much. Let's just keep it like that. And not much of this either. And not much of that either. I'm really low on materials. Or at least auto-crafted materials. Get myself a few or these things. And, well, let's see. Do I have these things actually put in my system? I believe I do. So I can simply auto-craft them. I got that going. Enemy pipe. Pattern. I got everything besides the pattern thingy. So, yeah. That should be good. Let's see. Then I need to do this. What else did I need? One of these. Then I needed a crafting table. And a storage thingy. And of course, I forgot I was low on these things. Get myself. And of course, I'm low on that again. Oh, I hate it when I'm low on materials. Always. Okay, that's one. And now I need one more conversion matrix, or two of those. Then I need two of these surface tanks. There we go. And I think I got everything. Yep. One fluid crafting chamber. What I've seen from videos, I luckily don't need this connected in the same way as these thingies, so that should save me a lot of time. So basically, all it should be is a simple hookup and it's done. So let's see. Can I simply do something like this? Put my wand away. Like this. And then I need to get myself a pattern which... how do I actually encode patterns? I need to get myself a water bucket. I believe it is. So let's see if that actually works, if I simply place a water bucket in this thing. Or I need some sort of pattern. No. I've actually not yet used these things ever in any world. So let's see. If I put myself like a bucket in this thing. And I get out a water bucket. And will this work? And no. Yeah, I'll go quickly look it up and I'll be right back. Ah, thanks to Bevo on the server, he luckily made a spotlight about this thing. I figured out that I don't even need to add that, but simply I got this recipe in, which is this thing, this recipe. So pretty much what I can do now is, for example, do I have any mossy stone? 17, quickly get that out. Let's say request that, and it will automatically get out the water out of my system. I can quickly see that here. Water. Like there. And it's refilling again. So now I should have myself a stack of moss. Pretty cool. And this thing also functions for lots of other stuff. For example, he used in his, in his demonstration, he used coolant cells. But, you know, you can use many, many, many other things. So that's cool. One more thing. Done. Then I want to get myself a fisher setup. It's not like I need a lot of fish, like, ever. But, you know, it might as well be useful someday to me, so... might as well do it now, and... not working right. I believe Mine Factory Reloaded has a nice solution for fishing, so let's see. Mine Factory Reloaded. Planter... fisher. Yeah. Cool. For that, I need... fisher... three fishing rods. One, two, three. Two buckets. I can craft those. 10, why not? It's not like I'm low on materials or anything. Planter or a fisher. There we go. Then I need a jabber barrel. Seriously, I need to add these things to my system. Jabber barrel. Yeah, that will be a pain. Let's see. Chest. I can autocraft them, yep. Then slabs. Can I autocraft them? No, I cannot yet. So let's see. Add that to my system too. Oh wait, I said I need to use normal wood, right? Yeah. Wood. Then use this. Damn it. do this and this. Three of these. I'm failing. Then I need to do this, 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 no, this. And then I need to get these slabs. There we go. Put this in there. Get me one Jabba barrel. So let's see. What I can do then is barrels. I'll place this right there. And the oak slabs can go there. What I need to do is change this up, change this one up, change this one up, change this one up, this one, this one. And I think that's pretty much it. Do I have sticks? Redwood? Yeah, took them out. So I can quickly change all these things up, as you can see. Because I want to change this up to normal wood. Then two of these. Then this one. Because you know, now I got myself a normal wood farm. I no longer need to use this wood, which I mainly use for decorational stuff. So yeah, it's nice. Then bookshelves. I got that set to that. Oh well, like this. And a piston, also to normal stuff. Nice. Then dump all of this back in here. And yep, that's all. And then I should be able to simply request myself a better barrel. Like, say 10. There we go. I only need one, of course, but yeah. Then, do I still have trans? Nope, I do not. Well, I should be able to simply place them next to that farm, so energy conduits should... redstone energy conduits should pretty much suffice, I hope. And some dirt would be nice too. Might as well get that going. Yeah. What I should be able to do is make like a little something right here. And quickly walk over that, turn it all to grass. Yeah. I should. Technically. It only needs a, I believe it's a 1x1 space of water, but I'm not sure about that. Otherwise I can always change it up. Yeah, quickly break this all, see if this will work. And yeah, it cleaned itself out. Then I need to place myself a barrel, I believe it's on top of this thing. It's been quite a long time since I used these things, so yeah. And then I should be able to hook this up underneath, like there. Then get right there under my farm. And turn it over to right there. Then like that, and this should theoretically be working. Hey, what do you know? It's working. Quite a long idle time. Let's see. It's actually working. No, it's not working. Why is this work thing stalled? If I place this like right there, does that change anything up? No. Why is this not working? I assumed it pretty much worked the same, like it did before. Oh wait, of course it's not underneath water. Duh, I'm an idiot. Get my wrench out. Oh, I also changed everything up to this bag, so I no longer need to carry around three different kinds of bags, especially with all these things. So now I'm storing it all like right there. Pretty cool. Then I'll, you know, break this. So I can still run it like right here. Then up there, there. Put my fisher down there. And now my barrel. And This should not work. Why not? Does it really need a 3x3 place underneath it? Really now? Or is it just trolling with me? I'm not an expert on mods. I know my way around them, but I'm no expert with them, so. Could be wrong, could be right. Hey, I was right. So now, this thing should be producing a bunch of fish for me. Sooner or later. This definitely takes its time. Slow fisher. Oh well, it's not like I'm gonna need like 900 ticks is... let's quickly do the math. How long is it? Like 40, 45 seconds? Yeah, 45 seconds. It's not like I need one fish every 45 seconds, but yeah, it's working. Nice. Cool. So that's one more easily to do job done. Woohoo. So let's see. Get back over here. Open this book. Fisher is done. Now, I quickly want to make my own private portal to the Twilight Forest. I've already been to the Twilight Forest a few times, but that's thanks to the portal at spawn, the public one. But it would be nicer to have my own portal. And luckily, it is a very inexpensive job to do, so yeah. So let's see, I need two water buckets and a bunch of flowers. What flowers would be nice? I can simply use vanilla flowers, I guess, because I got myself a flower farm. Or maybe use some of these other flowers. I'm not sure if they all work, but two of those, 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 and I need 12, I guess, so two of those. See if this will work. Where should I make this portal? Well, I guess right here would be nice. Or, maybe... Yeah, it doesn't have to be such a large space, but it has to be a 4x4, and this thing won't be symmetrical, and I would hate that, absolutely. Then I'll just place it symmetrical to this room, or roof, thingy, like. And, of course, I missed done this. Do this. Get this going. Then put one water bucket there and one there. Then my flowers can go right there, right there, right there, right there. I'm making it more of like a Tomcraft setup, like the symmetrical around every thingy. And then I should simply be able to throw a diamond in this thing and have it work. So, let's see. Please work. By the power. Yeah. Whoa. Took a minute to update. Awesome. Now I got my own private Twilight Forest portal. So, let's hop through and see what I can find on the other side. Downloading terrain. Yeah, download quicker. there we go. Nice. Minimap, please show up in just a second so I can see what's going on. Just takes a moment because... Oh, there we go. Wait, have I already been here or... What is this? Wait, if I turn this on... damn key configs. Turn this on. There we go. Wow. This looks like a pretty nice area. Huh. Bit strange though. But pretty cool. Wow. Nice. Could be useful maybe someday. And what did I just see in my minimap? Oh, that's my home at the same coordinates. Cool. A dungeon. Oh, wow. Have I been there already? I'm not exactly sure of that. I'm not sure what my current coordinates are. But, let's see. If I come close, does it say something like a Twilight Lich? Hello, Mr. Lich. Are you still in here? Or have thou been slain yet? Let's quickly break. Nah. We're gonna do it the old-fashioned way and hope something goes in here. Is there a door? Ah, you guys all die. Put my wand out. Put it to the fire mode. Cool. Cool stuff. So let's see, what's in a Trollite of these thingies? Besides, of course, a bunch of bad and evil mobs. Which was pretty much to be expected, but let's see. Luckily, I'm pretty immune to damage, so let's quickly get this out, this out. Well, die! All of you! Huh, zombies falling down from the sky. Nice. Let's see, if I venture up here. And a skeleton spawner. Get you out of the way. I don't like skeletons. Get out. Burn to death. Cool towers. Let's see if there's any cool loot that I can find, actually. Because that's what I'm after, actually. And, oh. Don't fall down there. And I forgot that I can fly, but... What the hell? Flying books. Huh. That's awesome. Of course, you know. Nothing is weird in the... Well, nothing's weird in Minecraft. So, you know, flying books. Why not? That is probably what the maker of the Twilight Forest mod... Sorry, I completely forgot your name. But that's, I guess, what this guy would assume. And, yeah, there is the Twilight Lich. There is the Twilight Lich. Oh, let's see. How do I battle this thing? Can I do it like this? Can I burn y'all? Oh, wait. This is the Twilight Lich. Hey, this thing can break his shield. That's overpowered. That's really overpowered. Oh. Burn him to death. Oh, I can't burn him to death. Well, then, get you down, then, boom, one more shot, want to get these zombies out of the way before I kill him, boom, he's dead, nice, Twilight Lich, killed. I got myself a zombie scepter, which is nice, book and quill, Bane of Arthropods 3 sword, golden boots, don't need that, but the Lich trophy is what I'm mainly after. To show me that I am the boss of this stuff. That's awesome. Do these trophies have a use? Apparently not. But what is this zombie scepter? What the hell? Huh. A loyal zombie. Cool. Not many uses, but... apparently I can recharge this thing. That's awesome. Does this also fight for me? Hey, yeah, it does. That's awesome. Oh, let's see if I can... Let's hope if I can actually find a use for this stuff. Ah, that's cool. Is there actually anything written in this? Nah, it isn't. That's cool. So, yeah. I guess it would be a good wrapping up point for episode 28. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any suggestions or anything, feel free to let me know in the comment section down below. I always read all my comments and I always appreciate feedback, of course. As many YouTubers do. But other than that, if you're new to my channel, feel free to subscribe. And I hope to see you guys all next time.